अप टू विच लेवल, अप टू विच डिफिकल्टी लेवल द यूपीएससी इज बीइंग आस्किंग द क्वेश्चंस, राइट? सो दैट यू नीड टू डू. हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, ग्रीटिंग्स ऑफ द डे एंड माई सेल्फ प्रियंका गोदारा, फैकल्टी मैथ्स ऑप्शनल प्लूटस आईएएस. एंड टुडे वी आर हेयर टू डिस्कस सम ऑफ द टिप्स एंड ट्रिक्स फॉर द मैथ्स ऑप्शनल. सो मैथ्स ऑप्शनल इज बीइंग कंसीडर्ड वन ऑफ द स्कोरिंग सब्जेक्ट एंड इट इज नॉट ओनली बीइंग कंसीडर्ड, इट हैज प्रूव टाइम एंड अगेन दैट लॉट ऑफ द स्कोलर्स these toppers has scored very high marks in maths optional, and sometimes we have seen that even first ranker has maths optional, the example being Kanishk Kataria. And so can you think that just doing randomly maths optional and you would be landing up in the top ranks under 50 or for some time you can say under 10? No, for that what you require that preparation should be managed, it should be strategized, and it should be framed into timely manner. So let's see some of the tricks, and the tricks would start. It is not like that there would be some of the magic. No, usual practice would be there, but it should be managed, it should be organized. So how to start? The strategy here is, for getting started, first thing I always do say, there are two navigators and one is syllabus, another one to recognize your approach, that is your PYQs. So do analyze your syllabus properly. Analyze the syllabus, and while analyzing, what you need to do, you need to underline the topics which you know. And if there must be some of the familiar topics, because if you are selecting maths optional, then I would assume that you have some of the basics or some of the basics in mathematics, be it your up to 12th standard or be it your master's or engineering background. So there are some of the topics that most of you would be familiar, and finalize these topics. And out of these topics, what you need to do? You need to go through the PYQs of at least 20 years and then understand the pattern. That what kind of questions UPSC is asking. For instance, if I want to give you the example, then linear algebra is one of the subject, and here matrix transformation, or you can say linear transformation, is one of the topic that UPSC asks every year, be it your 15 marker, 17 marker or 20 markers, but without any fail UPSC do ask that question. And second thing, what if you do take example of vector analysis, then we always have three theorems, that is Gauss theorem, divergence theorem and Stokes theorem. So these are the Stokes theorems. That one question would be there properly asked every year. Another thing, if you want to know about partial differential equation, then they would ask to form canonical form. This question more often repeats in the exam. And similarly, heat equation, wave equation, or Laplace equation. So these are three equations that you need to solve under partial differential equation, and UPSC asks questions from these themes. So what you need to do? You need to understand the pattern. You need to understand the important themes. And out of these themes also, you need to understand that what kind of question, what kind here I means, that up to which level, up to which difficulty level the UPSC is being asking the questions, right? So that you need to do. Then after going through these two navigators, that is one is syllabus, another one is PYQs, what you need to do? Now this is the time for your action. What kind of action? First thing, you should make a schedule, and that schedule should be for the entire syllabus. And one guide I would say, that if you are preparing for maths optional, then you should finish your syllabus at least 6 months prior to the prelims. I don't know when you would be giving your first attempt, but if you have to be on the safer side, then you should attempt or you should try to finish your syllabus at least 6 months before the prelims. Why I'm saying 6 months before the prelims? Isn't it enough that before 2 months you do cover the syllabus completely and then you can shift over the prelims mode that people usually do, that before prelims they would be leaving each and everything and that would start mugging up the facts that this is the prelim specific preparation. I don't understand that kind of preparation, but if still you want to go into that mode, that is your choice. But why I'm saying that 6 months before the syllabus, there is logic behind this one. What kind of logic? That finishing your syllabus, learning and finishing the syllabus is just 25% of your preparation. You have just covered 25% of preparation, still 75% is remaining. What is that 75%? That is 50% of that time of yours should be devoted for the practice and more practice. Dear aspirant, until and unless you do lot of practice in mathematics, then completing the syllabus is in vain. This is not going to produce any fruit for you, and that is why you need more and more practice, and that is why I said that finish your syllabus at least 6 months prior to your prelims. Next thing, after doing this thing, scheduling and everything, then how to start studying? So for studying, what you need to do? Categorize your syllabus under three heads. One is easy units, second one is medium difficulty units, and third one is difficult units. And as fast as you can, first finish your easy units, then focus over hard units. And hard units should be put on the last, and that these hard units would be giving you equal marks and it would be requiring you lot of time of yours. So here you have to work very smartly. Choose the topic which would be ensuring you maximum marks into minimum investment of time. Okay, don't invest your maximum time into hard units, because you are here for clearing UPSC, you are not here to do PhD or mathematics optional, right? So strategize accordingly. Easy topics, medium difficulty level topics and hard topics, that varies person to person, that what is their background. But in generalization, if I do consider that average of the students, then easy units everywhere they do find out is linear algebra, then numerical analysis, then vector analysis, ODE, PDE, LPP. Whatever background you do have, mostly all the students do find out that these units are very much easier. So do finish them as early as you can, then go for the medium units, and medium units are being considered calculus, real analysis, complex analysis, then mechanics, fluid dynamics and analytical geometry. And then hardest unit, they are not hardest, but sometimes you may feel that you are not familiar with that, and people do consider that most of the time physics portion, that they usually say that this is the physics portion under maths optional. But in my class, I usually say that this is not the physics, this is the mathematics only, because in these portions, what we do, a little bit of concept of physics would be used. Otherwise, you would be doing only mathematical calculation on the basis of the formulas, right? So hardest unit, usually we consider that modern algebra, statics and dynamics. So keep them in the last and then do finish them according to the time, remaining time, that how much time you do have. Next thing, this is the time division. I already have told you that just finishing the syllabus isn't enough for mathematics optional. That is just 25% of your preparation, 75% is remaining. Out of 75%, 50% should be devoted into practicing lot of questions, practice and practice more. That is why I said, if you finish your syllabus 6 months prior to prelims, then what you will do for next 3 months, do practice, and after that, whenever you would be writing mains, that after your prelims you would be getting enough time for going for test series and that too in exam mode. And this is very much important. Sometimes people would be saying that when we would be completing maths optional, then every time we are just practicing a lot of questions, and then why to go for the test series? One thing it would be telling you, that increase your speed. It would keep a tap over the speed of yours in the exam. Second thing, it would increase your accuracy. And that is pretty much required in maths optional. If your answer is incorrect, that is, doesn't matter, it is on the last line, but examiner would award you only half of the marks, because nobody do take that headache to check in which step you have committed the mistake. No examiner would do that, right? And third thing what you will get from here is you will get an idea how to select a question, that is question selection. And all these three things are very much required to enhance your marks. This would maximize your marks, right? Then next thing is proof of the theorems. People usually do have this doubt that, ma'am, do we require to do all the proofs of the theorem? See, if you do have pure mathematics background, then mostly you have done all the proofs, and then that is okay for you to revise them with the preparation only. But if your background is simple BSc or background is simple your engineering, then mostly it is not possible that you have done the mathematics from the proof perspective, right? And at that time, in the initial stage when you are preparing, at that time just note down the theorems, because result would be used. Just note them down the theorem and don't go for the proof. Then in the second or third iteration, when you would be covering your syllabus, when you are practicing, then at that time what you need to do after completing your syllabus, see the past year papers and then analyze that which kind of theorem and from which unit UPSC is being asking. Then according to the pattern of the exam, do your theorems proof, right? So be selective in doing theorems proof, because UPSC does not focus much over the proof of the theorem. Usually earlier than 4 to 5 years before, UPSC usually asked the theorem from modern algebra. But nowadays they are also focusing in the modern algebra as well on the application part. There would be questions from homomorphism, automorphism, that kind of thing. And there you require applicability of the results, applicability of the theorems. That is why always note down the theorem's result. Do remember it by heart. But proof you may skip for the first initial preparation and do it in the second level of preparation according to the pattern of exam. Be selective here. Then books and books or ready-made notes. Students do have this, you can say, capacity or appetite for getting notes. Ma'am, notes mil jayenge to baat ban jayegi kya, notes mil jayenge to itna enough hai kya. I don't know why they opt for notes, that maybe ki thode se kam hote hain, thoda ye lagta hai ki kisi ne haath se likha hai to thoda jaldi padha jayega. But I would always recommend, it may help you in your GS papers, may help you in somewhere else, but in mathematics optional, my suggestion is opt for standard books. Why? Standard textbooks, because you get the first hand information directly from the author. In notes, mostly what happens, whoever is writing the notes, that would be from the perspective as well as from the knowledge level of that person, that how much they can understand. It depends that you may understand that thing, you may find out that is they are writing something excessive, or you may find out that you require more explanation. But in the books, writer would be writing everything, and have your preparation from the standard books. Then disclaimer, what is this? That sometimes people do say, ma'am, if we are doing this book, is it enough to cover this one? No, my dear, books and all the study materials, they are not for UPSC. They are for one of the university exam, or they are for any of the research purpose. But they none of the book out there in the market is for properly UPSC. And that is why what you need to do, map your syllabus and then refer to different books for different topics. One suggestion here again, for one topic, refer only one book. Don't run after the number of books. It is not required. Instead of doing one topic from 10 books. Do one topic 10 times from one book only. Are you getting it? That instead of doing one topic from 10 different books, do this one topic 10 times from the same book, and that would keep you like more revised. That would be providing you more clarity again and again rather than confusing you. Then next thing, and nowadays people do have this thing that, ma'am, should we study in the groups? Should we join these WhatsApp groups, Facebook groups, Telegram groups? Everywhere you would be having lot of information, and everywhere there would be lot of channels. N number of channels are there in the market that would be providing you that these are the things, this is the study material that you should refer. Everywhere you would be getting guidance. Guidance is like, now earlier it was used to say that Indians have this hobby of डिस्ट्रीब्यूटिंग ज्ञान, कि सबको ज्ञान देना हमारी आदत है, चाहे किसी को चाहिए ना चाहिए. अब वो ज्ञान यहाँ पे यूपीएससी प्रिपरेशन हो, कोई भी और एग्जाम प्रिपरेशन हो, हमेशा मिलता रहता है. बट द क्वेश्चन इज इट हेल्पिंग यू? सो ग्रुप्स हेल्प. आई डोंट से दैट ग्रुप्स डजंट हेल्प, बट मेक ए ग्रुप ऑफ 2 to 3 फ्रेंड्स ओनली. इट शुड बी मैक्सिमम 3 फ्रेंड्स, एंड ऑल ऑफ योर फ्रेंड्स शुड बी इक्वली सीरियस as serious you are for the exam. Otherwise, it may backfire for you. Another thing, if you are in one of the WhatsApp group or one of the Telegram channel, use it wisely. Everything there is not for you. If there, in particularly if I do talk about mathematics optional, then in these channels, I have seen that lot of people would be sharing their problems. Don't get involved in these conversations that thank you, welcome, etc., etc. No. What you need to do, choose these problems as your practice question. Do practice them. If you are able to solve them, share it as a help, but that is okay. That is it. After that, you don't need to keep on a tab that who is commenting after this one, who is saying thank you to you, who is praising you. No, you don't need to do that thing. So don't get involved in the conversations. Do use these groups or these channels as your practice medium, as your practicizer. Otherwise, if you are wasting a lot of your time over these channels, then my dear friend, that is not for you. Opt out of that channel as soon as you can. Okay guys, so these are the tips and tricks for Maths Optional. See you in the next video after some time. Thank you.